camp. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
Hi, Todd. Nice to be here with you.
It's time for our tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali. Rocky Marciano. What a unique environment. And we're underway in round one. What a world championship fight we're seeing, ladies and gentlemen. From this guy, he needs to bury the chest and pound away.
Oh man, you've got a swarm in your face. You've got to try and push him off, make him go into the rope. You've got to sometimes fight fire with fire. Put me on the blind side of the referee.
I know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Dominant round there. Let's see how they respond here in the next round. There's the bell for round two. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one.
Say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can
turn it around here.
This is one of those situations. You just be hurt, you've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be strong. Don't be a fool. Don't get sucked in. Make you fight. You're fine. Hold them. Tie them up. Just until your head clears again. And your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
Something has got it. good chin? Do they have a glass jaw? Those are questions that are being answered here tonight.
The problem with having a chin that everybody knows if they hit you, you're not, you're gone. You've got to protect that, but you've also got to get your shots off. And this is this. You can bang too. I'm fighting around and you're pretty much eating either.
With a granite chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer. They are not going to move.
some mad punches, but a chin right across. As soon as you touch them, they've gone. This is the danger.
The ref knew exactly what he was doing. So you know what? Great shout. I look forward to fight number two.
Shoot for the score. Hey, if I had a penny for everyone that'd be, I'll make a million a month off of
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is go time. My name is Todd Grisham. And here with me, my broadcast colleague, it's Johnny Nelson.
Todd, it's going to be an amazing night. As per usual, everybody's going to benefit.
It's time for our tale of the tape. Rocky Marciano. He's 5 foot 10 inches tall, one of the great. The Rock, Rocky Marciano. The smoking Joe Frazier. His three battles with Muhammad Ali, perhaps the most famous the sport has ever seen. So they stare into each other's eyes one final time, touch gloves, and get prepared for battle. Great to have you with us for this all-action affair. We expect big things, and I don't think we're going to be disappointed. Both men step back for just a moment. Counter right. Not a lot of punch output. Thought there would be some more action here. Left counter scores. You're not going to see a lot of finesse and skills from this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in your chest and pound away.
Oh, man, you've got swarm in your face. You've got to try and push him off, maybe going to the rope. You've got to sometimes fight fire with fire. Hit him low on the blind side of the referee. Get him angry.
You got to like what you're seeing as we reach the halfway point of this round. Perfect counter lands. Neither fighter willing to sit down on these punches. They're arm punches. They're scoring, but they're not going to hurt anybody. Exchange punches. When someone punches that hard, you don't want to trade shots. Don't worry about it. cards are going to be all over the place in this one. Talk about a one-sided 3 minutes. We just saw it.
Dominance without a doubt.
And there's the bell for round two. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Nice job landing that left counter punch. They both won the knockout. You're not going to see a lot of finesse and skills from this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in your chest and pound away.
You got a swarm on your case. You know you've got to fight. You've got to hold him. You've got to tie him up. You've got to lean on him when he come in until the referee makes you break up. But keep your hands high, because I will keep punching until that referee says stop.
Punch, counter punch. Real good back and forth between these two fighters. He's got out of the way that right hook. Nice job landing with that right hand counter. Either man really defending themselves. Men step back for just a moment. That left counter was perfectly timed. Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. As bad as boxing judging can be sometimes, there's no doubt who won that round.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as the fighter.
On to the third. Coming off that fantastic last round. Let's see if he can keep his momentum going. Offensive display landing that left counter. This fight is all about distance for this man, and you can see he's using that length advantage.
Very smart, very sharp. This is a fit young man style that he's got to get inside that long. Not many fights can do that.
He threw the hook, didn't land. Counter punching. Nice exchange here from both men. Halfway through the round, and there's not a lot separating these two. One moment changes everything, especially in this division. Left counter punch will score. Catch and shoot. This is some of the best action I've seen in any round, anywhere this year. And this is a you hit me hard, I'll hit you hard type of fight. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. Great counter right hand there. They've got the momentum. They've got the advantage. How do they carry that into the next round?
As long as they don't get complacent. You think this is too easy. If they keep this same kind of pace up, they've got this fight.
To the fourth round. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Positives and negatives in the heavyweight division are the same. You can win the fight with one punch, and you can lose the fight with one punch.
Because they're so big, because they can push, because they've got the weight behind them, they may not be connecting, but trust me, when they connect, that's when this fight sets on fire, because someone's going to get hurt, and someone's going to react.
He just misses with that big right hand. Fails to score with that left hook. Halfway through the round, and it's pretty much even for Steven. Both know who the bigger power puncher is. There's a significant power difference. How would you handle that?
Todd, we know one of these fighters can knock you out with a simple jab. They're that powerful.
Lands with the right counter. You'd like to see more jabs. Not a lot of punch output. Thoughts there might be more action here. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. Perfect counter shot. We know they've got the advantage so far, but how does this match get turned around?
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's a...
There's the bell for round 5. Last round, complete domination. Let's see what we have in store for us here.
Todd, my motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing, because you've won it, hands down.
Finding a second win. I don't think I need to tell you which one of these fighters needs to find it.
Now this is about desire. This is about character. This is about want.
Wait a minute. A left hand lands. Left hook missed. Missing with the hook. Cards are going to be all over the place in this one. Well, there was no doubt about who won that round.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight, because if they haven't, there's going to be absolutely...
This is the beginning of round 6. Can they seal the deal in this round after what we saw just a minute ago? When you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you.
That power might be the do or die. That power might be the equalizer.
We've seen seen in the past from this fighter, they don't get concerned when they lose some of the earlier rounds because they know they've got that power that can strike at any moment. By the way, the connect percentages have to be off the charts. Tough to be a judge in this fight as both fighters have had their big moments. The old adage is, no matter how much speed you've got, timing beats speed.
Having so much speed, what happens to your opponent is you get cut to ribbons, and that's where the referee has to jump in and stop the fight. And you know this is going to happen, so you rush your work. You think, I've got to get him inside close round.
Both men step back for just a moment. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. After what we saw in that last round, it's pretty obvious who has the advantage here.
Dominance, without a doubt, made it look so, so easy.
There's the bell to start round seven. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Good left hand. That left hand misses. There's no way this fighter can go punch for punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
What a gift. What a gift it is to have a chin where you know you can walk through anything and everything. When you let those shots go and it's just bouncing off and they're walking you down, it's so demoralizing. It absolutely breaks your heart. What else can you do?
Exchange here from both men. That hook was thrown with some bad intentions. That right hook catching air. Man really defending himself. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. I promise you, all three judges here are going to give that round to you-know-who.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight, because if they haven't, there's going to be absolute uproar.
Round eight, and we're off again. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. Both know who the bigger power puncher is. There's a significant power difference. How would you handle that?
It's the one who draws first blood, Todd. That's what you've got to look at. If you're here and you know you're in there with a banger, you've got to be on it. You've got to be confident.
Missed him with that uppercut. It has been a back and forth contest so far, no doubt about it. He just gets out of the way of that right uppercut. think it's safe to say one of these fighters certainly has a significant speed advantage. You can tell who it is.
When you have a fighter that's got that great footwork and that great hand speed, it's so hard. It's an uphill battle.
Rocky Marciano covering up, trying to buy some time to get out of trouble. I thought we were going to see the finish there. This round could go either way, 10 seconds to go. He is down big time on the scores.
The bell, sometimes it can be the sweetest sound.
Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if he can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on him. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
And he misses with that jab. They threw the hook, but it didn't land. Looking to land the hook. You gotta like what you're seeing as we reach the halfway point of this round. Power is obviously the great equalizer in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it?
I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone. Forget tactics. They know the second they touch you, it's done. That's where the confidence comes from.
Why are they throwing punches? They should be playing defense right now. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this game. Was almost a 10-8 round, complete dominance.
As long as they don't get complacent, you think this is too easy. If they keep this same kind of pace.
And here comes the 10th round. And they seal the deal in this round after what we saw just a minute ago. He blocks the hook. You're a power puncher, you're not as concerned with how many punches you throw, it's about how many you land. Are we witnessing one of the all-time greats go down? Oh, do you believe this? Rocky Marciano is down!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
So they'll make it up, and this fight continues. He carries away that left hook. He misses with that jab. The right hook. Ooh. blocked. Not a lot of punch output. Thought there might be more action here. So 10 seconds of the round, and he is looking really sharp. He's been knocked down, but at least not knocked out yet.
Can make or break a fighter.
Let's start 11. Let's see how he bounces back here after getting dropped in the last round.
Oh, listen to me. If I knock somebody down like that, that's right. You know this round coming up? He's getting everything, full foul, because I know his legs are strong. So this, you watch what's going to happen. If he doesn't, I'll be very, very surprised.
We've seen in the past from this fighter, they don't get concerned when they lose some of the earlier rounds.
Is this the beginning of the end for this legend?
Has he weathered the storm? Looks like they're out of trouble. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Just misses with that jab. There's a big difference between being the aggressor and the effective aggressor. Which type are we seeing so far?
I've seen some aggressive fighters like this, and they are a nightmare. If you are not fit, that is the worst place to be, having second thoughts in the ring.
Competitive round with 10 seconds left. It's no secret who has the advantage after that last round. Let's see what they have in store for us in the next one.
You caught.
On to the 12th. Last round, complete domination. Let's see what we have in store for us here. And he just missed with that left jab. There's no doubt that this fighter's power can change the fight around in an instant. You can't afford to make one single minor mistake.
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take you out with a simple jab, it can be intimidating. It just depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
Good fight so far. Both of these fighters have had their moments. Left shot lands. I see more jabs. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. What a dominant performance, and it shows up on the judges' scorecards as a unanimous decision victory.
What a whitewash. You know, that's skills, that's class, that's levels. One is up there, one is down there, but you know what? The loser is going to have to learn a big, big, hard lesson. I totally agree.
Only one, number one, there ain't room for two.
There ain't no room.
I am the one. Top two, but not number two.
There ain't no room.
Boom. Came in, cleaned up without a broom.
There ain't no room.
Still here, still not been moved. I got points to prove.
There ain't no room.
Straight in, more pain, so more gaining. Here I came in, guns blazing. At Raven, you get weighed in. Been training, sick of waiting. Some failing, not plain sailing. Entertaining, check the ratings. Let me out, I don't wanna be caged in. Yeah, I'm ready, who's next up? Pay attention now, yeah, your best luck. I like to warm up like a few jabs, and then I hit hard like a left hook. My style's unique, not.
They've been talking the talk. It's now time to walk the walk. This is the Lighthouse Theater. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me, former world champion Johnny Nelson.
About time to.
And now it's time for the tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali. He stands 6'3" tall with a 78-inch reach. He is the greatest of all time. Muhammad Ali. The Rock. Rocky Marciano, 201 pounds. A lot of trash talk between these two fighters. Now it's... These athletes have been waiting a long time to square off. Here we go. What's that, jab? Changes everything, especially in this division. That counter shot lands. Either man really gets confused. It's been a back and forth contest so far, no doubt about it. Walk away from each other and then run right back into trouble. Back in the out of finesse and skills with this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in the chest and pound him.
Oh man, you've got swim in your face. You've got to try and push him off, make it going for a while. You've got to sometimes fight with fire. Hit me on the downside of the referee.
Both men step back for just a moment. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Well, we're entering desperation mode here. Gonna need a knockout.
Needs a knockout without a doubt. Needs a block.
Rings the bell to start round two. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations that just being hurt, you've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be a fool. Don't be suckered in. Make him fight your fight. Hold him. Tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
Thank you. fails to score with that left hook. And he just missed that left jab. Puncher is. There's a significant power difference. How would you handle that?
Todd, we know one of these fighters can knock you out with a simple jab. They're that powerful.
He just misses with that jab. You'll get knocked out. Right through the ramp. I mean, these two are going at it. Talk about punches and bunches. That's the mantra for this fighter with that exceptional hand speed.
Maybe a flashback if they were to cut you to ribbons, and they know it's a matter of time before either you get desperate or the referee jumps in and saves you. This is a nasty good gift.
Side, pick a side, where you that rideth every man and woman that cometh into this continent, into this world of America today.
Grisham, and there is a buzz in the air here tonight with the Empire Fight Camp. Next to me, of course, is Johnny Nelson.
It's going to be unbelievable. The fans around the world, the fighters, this is just one of those things.
Time for our tale of the tape. He is Rocky Marciano, the Brockton Brawler. This heavyweight is anything but standing only 5'10" tall, 200. Rocky Marciano, the Brockton Brawler himself, one of the greatest fighters of all time, a sparkling record. The Bronze Bomber, fighting out of Tuscaloosa, Alabama, the former heavyweight champion of the world.
Just take note, Todd. Check that out.
Underneath the moonlight, and what a fight it should be.
It's cooled down a little bit. The fight.
And we're off and running between these two really accomplished fighters. See how they come out.
Push them off balance because they will just stay in your face.
Get the
halfway point, and both of these fighters know the round is still up for grabs. And so far, the offense has been better than the defense.
Opponent.
to ribbons, and that's when the referee has to jump in and stop the fight. And you know this is going to happen, so you rush your work and think, I've got to get him inside close round.
This fighter's not interested in throwing one shot at a time. They throw combinations, and they throw them non-stop. Every competitive round with 10 seconds left. Advantage so far, but how does this match get turned around?
Dominance, without a doubt, Meg looks so, so easy.
Things are starting to heat up now as we enter the fifth. Last round, complete domination. Let's see what we have in store for us here.
My motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing because you've won it, hands down.
Marciano was supposed to be the one knocking this guy out. Much better game plan here. Power is obviously the great equalizer in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it?
It could be really intimidating, Tom. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take out with a simple jab, it can be intimidating. It depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
This has been a very competitive round between these two. Certainly has a significant speed advantage. You can tell who it is.
I've never seen a fighter so fast in my life. How do you deal with this? You've got to hope. You've got to hope they run out of speed.
Tell you which one of these fighters needs to find it.
You wait through the fight, you walk out, this is something the loneliest place in the world. If you cheated, now we're gonna find out.
Watch the jab. In this one.
exerted a lot of energy in the fight so far, and now they're shattered. This is what we call championship rounds. If you have done the work, slept right, ate right, slept right, I'm expecting you to get cheated. If not, if you cheated, the ring can be the boldest place in the world.
Certainly has a significant speed advantage. You can tell who it is.
So you get in there with someone that's so fast, you're prepared to take a licking, because you're gonna get some before you get in close.
Talk about punches and bunches. That's the mantra for this fighter with that exceptional hand speed. At the halfway point of this round, and both of these fighters have had their moments. Still could go either way. Somehow.
Now this is about desire. This is about character. This is about want.
Thank you.
phrase, finding a second win. I don't think I need to tell you which one of these fighters needs to find it.
Midway through the fight, you are tired. This can be the longest place in the world.
You cheated.
This fighter can go the punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
Sometimes on a day when your back is coming out, and your punch can hit you. Well, you want that spaceship to kind of lift you out there because you think, what the hell are you going to do next?
Championship material.
There's the belt for round 11. A lot of energy put into that last round. Can they keep it up here?
What are they doing that now? Are they trying to get an early round? That's a lot of energy. They did six rounds in one. They're going to be absolutely shattered.
Talk about fighter having power. Don't just look at the head punches that day.
Look at the body shots. That could be the real difference.
Power. That power might be the do or die. That power might be the equalizer.
From the spider, they don't get concerned when they lose some of the earlier rounds because they know they've got that power that can strike at any moment. Through the hook, didn't land. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. Chase a superior athlete around the ring and just get picked apart, even though they were the one pushing the tempo.
I've seen some aggressive fighters. They can terrorize the life out of you before they've even thrown the shot. The strength they have, the speed they have, and that knockout punch, they want to punch through you. They don't want to punch you. They want to punch straight through you. So you've got to be careful.
This round can go either way.
Now they're doing it again, and look what's happened. A unanimous decision. What a way, what tactics, what a game plan. What a result.
Only one number one, there ain't room for two.
There ain't no room.
I am the one. Top two, but not number two.
There ain't no room. Boom.
Came in clean though.
undoubtable.
There ain't no room.
Still here, still not been moved. I got points to prove.
There ain't no room.
Straight in, more pain, so more gaining. Here I came in, guns blazing. At raving, you get weighed in. Been training, sick of waiting. Some failing, not plain sailing, entertaining.
I'm Todd Grisham. The fighters are here, and they're about to get it on at the Lighthouse Theater. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
The pleasure's always mine, my friend.
Time for our tale of the tape. Rocky Marciano. He's 5'10" tall, one of the greatest heavyweights to ever live. Undefeated. And across the ring from him, Tyson Fury. He stands an imposing 6'9" tall, with a reach of 85 inches. Rocky Marciano, 201 pounds of pure terror. This man is an absolute machine. The Gypsy. One of the hottest tickets around. And there's the bell to start round one. Stronger, but he's not faster. Scores that right up the top. The crowd is dressed to impress here tonight, and the fighters promise to do the same, as we cannot wait for this, our main event.
Well, a fighter walking into a theater, I think this is the closest thing to fighting in a gym, because the people are up close. You can hear people talking ringside. You can hear people jeering, saying how good you are, saying how bad you are. You can hear the pressure, the expectation.
Both men. Coming back to life now, starting to land some punches. Nice counter shot. Step back for just a moment. Round with 10 seconds left. Well, he is glad to avoid that bell.
Wow, it's like two different leagues.
To say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if he can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on him. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet, not until your senses have come back.
Finesse and skills from this guy. Bury his forehead in your chest and pound away.
You are fighting the swarm. Be smart, be sharp. Concentrate where you've got to be confident. Do not dance his dance, because that swarm, once you do that, you're giving him a chance that shouldn't have.
He's going to keep his elbows tucked into the chest so he can avoid the pain of those body shots. But that leaves more opportunity for headshots. Halfway through the round, and man, these two are going at it. fighter willing to sit down on these punches. They're arm punches. They're scoring, but they're not going to hurt anybody. He parries that punch. Time. You've got to get in there quick to punch your opponent before he gets his fist back to block.
The action is second to none. It's the blink of an eye. They wait for any little twist you do. So you've got to fight. Counter punch is smart.
Punch off first, and then you answer in kind. Both of these men showing exceptional chin, by the way. Both of these fighters have had their moments. Find a way to get around that reach advantage.
Nice small pull shot. This is the fit young man style that he's got to get inside that line. Not many fights can do that.
Here in the next one. Classes in the heavyweight division, but we don't care. We want that heavy fist.
Because they're so good, because they can push, because they've got the weight behind them, they may not be connected, but when they connect, that's when this back sets on fire. Because someone's going to get hurt, and someone's going to win.
This round can go either way, 10 seconds to go. We'll be right back.
safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations. You've just been hurt, you've got to go out there again. Be smart, be sharp. Don't be a fool, don't get suckered in. Make him fight your fight. Hold him, tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
Stools and ready to go. Let's hope this round is more competitive.
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they've got to block it. They've got to block it. They've got to come out now and style it out. Get on the back foot, jab, rest on the jab. Be smart and pop until your legs come back. Then, what a technique.
Is there's a significant power difference? How would you handle that?
Sometimes when you get in there with someone that's so powerful, thinking you've just got to be smarter than them. You've got to be like a little Fagin, a pickpocket.
Halfway through the round, and there's not a lot separating these two.
That last
last round and see what he has for us here in the next one. Correct me if I'm wrong, but when you're dealing with someone with so much speed, to get your timing right.
But you're getting in there with someone that's so fast, you're prepared to take a licking because you've got to get some before you get in close.
Back and forth, going this round. The momentum continues to shift. This fighter is certainly not going to outthrow their opponent by any means, but they will when they hit. See a lot of fun.
You've got to be courageous when you get in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster. You've just got to use brain.
In boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it? Just gets out of the way of that right uppercut. Grabs with just 10 seconds to go.
He's gonna throw the kitchen sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him off. Be smart because he's going to try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs are gone. He knows your head's not clear.
How strong is your chin? Do you have a glass chin? These are things that can affect the fight.
Hurt the body, frustrate, and take the mind off the chin. Take the mind off the fact of anything around that. Hurt the body, use tactics. Scratch out blocks of fight and beat them on points.
Between being the aggressor and the effective aggressor. Which type are we seeing so far?
We've seen some aggressive fighters like this. If you are not fit, that is the worst place to be. Having defending thoughts in those days.
Very competitive round with 10 seconds left. See if we can turn it around here. There's a scoring blow. Neither fighter willing to slow down. Thank you.
this fighter's aggression against him.
I've seen some aggressive fighters. They can terrorize the life out of you before they've even thrown a shot. The strength they have, the speed they have, and that knockout punch, they want to punch through you. They don't want to punch you. They want to punch straight through you. So you've got to be careful.
You got to like what you're seeing as we reach the halfway point of this round. Step back for just a moment. Why sit in a pocket when your punches are this slow? Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Almost a 10-8 round complete. There's the bell to start round 10. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going.
Me personally, I don't think it's possible. And if you can, their training, their conditioning would have been ridiculous. They're in the army. But these guys, if they can keep up this pace, we are in for it right now.
Might be more action here. They both want the knockdown. Oh.
to score with that left hook. I know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one.
Trying to get an early night. That's a lot of energy first. They did six rounds in one. They can absolutely shatter.
In the past in this fighter, they don't feel concerned when they lose some of the earlier rounds because they know they've got that power that can strike any moment.
So one who draws first blood, that's what he's going to look at. If you get, and you know you're in there with a banger, you've got to be honest, but you've got to be confident.
You're a power puncher. You're not as concerned with how many punches you throw. It's about how many you land and how hard they are. Fighters landing in these exchanges, judge is gonna have a key job. Aggression has been the key. This fighter just not slowing down.
How do you deal with an aggressive fighter? What do you do to fight fighters? How do you give it on back? Because that's where they come from. Oh, this is all
that left hand confuses. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left.
Unanimous. You know what? Smart savage. Total change of styles to make sure they got it. Had every round in the bag. There was no argument, no discussion, no mistake. It was so obvious.
Ain't no room, only one number one, there ain't room for two.
There ain't no room,
I am the one, top two but not number two.
There ain't no room, boom,
came in cleaned up without a room.
There ain't no room,
still here, still not been moved, I got points to prove.
There ain't no room,
straight in, more pain so, more gaining, here I came in, guns blazing, at raving, you get weighed in, been training, sick of waiting, some failing, not plain sailing, entertaining, check the ratings, let me out, I don't wanna be caged in, yeah I'm ready, who's next up, pay attention now, yeah your best luck, I like to warm up like a few jabs, and then I hit hard like a left hook, my style's unique, not textbook, step to me, you get yourself messed up, win or lose, still here, still not been moved, I got points to prove,
there ain't no room.
Only one number one, there ain't room for two.
There ain't no room,
I am the one. Top two but not number two.
There ain't no room, boom.
Came in cleaned up without a room.
There ain't no room,
still here, still not been moved, I got points to prove.
There ain't no room.
Only one number one, there ain't room for two.
There ain't no room,
I am the one. Top two but not number two.
There ain't no room, boom.
Came in cleaned up without a room.